Everybody's looking forward to the service starting Sunday, Sunday, celebrating Sunday. Everybody's looking forward to the service starting. Worshiping, worshiping,
yeah.
Worshiping, worshiping,
yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, talking core values.
Are these the Satan worshippers? These ones? No, he looks very satanic.
It's a symbol, and obviously it's a striking visual image, but it's also symbolising the blood of the children.
Blood of the children? The blood of the children, that's what I thought, satanic.
The children we find is fairly powerful because they do it from something
that you
can just
read
into it.
What you will, yeah. I read Satanism. He kind of confirmed it when you said blood of the children. Was that a Freudian slip?
Really think it's a coincidence that all of those people and more, there are a lot more of them, just happened to get hurt and require a boot.
Twenty-two restaurants in Tampa and Atlanta.
The grouper sandwich.
And ordered cod, grouper, and catfish.
Scooping out the crunchy grouper.
We then packed the fish up and sent samples off to a lab for DNA testing. Now get this, 33% of the restaurants in Atlanta gave us a cheaper fish than the one we ordered. At Noodles Restaurant, we ordered fried grouper, a local favorite. But what we really got, according to the lab, was an Asian farmed fish called swai. Grouper goes for $20 a pound, while swai costs about $3 a pound. So what the heck is swai? Swai comes mainly from Vietnam, specifically the Mekong Delta, not the cleanest water in the world. This video also shows swai, farmed in overcrowded fish ponds. In a statement to Inside Edition, a fish industry spokesman insists the fish are some of the safest seafood you can eat, and it's a healthy, affordable fish, period. We went back to Noodles, the place where we got the cheap swai instead of grouper.
We found out that instead of grouper, it was actually a cheaper farmed fish from Asia. How can you explain that? Guess she didn't want to tell me.
At Pascal's restaurant, we ordered catfish, but according to the lab, once again, we got swai.
How do you think that happened?
I have no idea. I apologize. I have no idea. I have to find out.
This is real meat, no compromise, made in front of you.
So you grew this chicken in these tanks behind us?
Yes.
Without ever slaughtering a chicken?
You could ask me that a thousand times, and the answer is yes, yes, yes. We grew it right here. They're getting the oxygen.
His company, Upside Foods, just received clearance from the USDA to start selling their meat, made at this production center in Emeryville, California.
We'll be able to produce 50 to 75,000 pounds of meat every year right away.
Others make a disgusting discovery when they're feeding their young children.
I pick up the bottle and hold it in the light, and I see worms like inching up.
And we poured it down the drain, and we saw the maggots on it.
Tonight, we uncover that the baby formula used by both of those moms were from different companies.
Well, 41 Action News reporter Dia Wall went to get answers for both of them. Dia.
Yeah, Mike and Rhiannon, tonight we're talking about two babies whose moms have one story. When they made bottles using powdered formula, they found worms inside.
You guys are not going to believe this. I found worms. Lots of worms.
Helen Williamson says they came from this can of Nutramigen, the formula she uses to feed her infant daughter.
Happened to glance over at the bottle and saw, you know, waves. And I pick up the bottle and hold it in the light, and I see worms, like, inching up.
She stopped.
It was a brand new bottle.
Okay, this is making me cringe, okay? Even when I did eat crab meat, I didn't eat this, okay? I stayed away from imitation crab meat. It was just something about the taste that was just like, what is this? What is this? Okay, I'm supposed to like this, right? And then in your head, you know something ain't right, and you still eat it, right? So when you're buying your $20, $25 sushi, this is what's in it, right? And it ain't real crab meat, right? It is fish paste with chemicals in it. I don't know what that is. Okay, some type of binder or whatever, but this is what it comes out and it looks like. Okay? Mm-mm. Somebody call the police. This is nasty, y'all. This is nasty. I ain't paying $20 for some sushi that got this in it. We need to protest. Protest, okay? Start using real crab meat for sushi if y'all want. And you think sushi high already? Let them even start using real crab meat. Motherfucker gonna skyrocket. That's nasty. Some of y'all gonna say y'all don't care. Eat real food, not food that's made in a plant. This is.
לשאלתך לפני כן, כוח אולטרנית מדפסת זו בתאי גזע שאנחנו יודעים למעל לשריר ולשומן, והיא יודעת להדפיס טונות ביום. טונות של בשר מטורבת ביום. זה רק לשם ההמחשה, אתה תוכל לבחור את הסטייק שלך, והמדפסת תתחיל לשחרר סטייקים בקצב תעשייתי. סיריליון, אני לא יודע אם אתה אוהב יותר שומן או פחות שומן. באמצע, view order, slide to print. ופה בעצם המדפסת מתחילה לייצר סטייקים. סטייקים, הייחודיות פה היא שתאי הגזע נשארים חיים אחרי שהם מודפסים. סטייק יהיה מוכן בסביב הדקה.
דקה.
השלב פה הוא שווה ערך לשלב שבו הפרה נודדת פצע. הפרה לוקח שנתיים עד שהיא נשחטת, היא מזהבת את העולם בתהליך. פה זה תהליך שהוא הרבה יותר קצר.
בלי
שטח, בלי מים, בלי חתימה פחמנית.
בלי פלטות
ובלי כלום.
איפה הסטייק?
הסטייק עכשיו מודפס, ועכשיו אנחנו נעבור ל...
זה המקדונלד'ס של העתיד.
כן, זה המקדונלד'ס, זו הקצבייה במשחטה של העתיד.
פאסט פוד.
וההפתעה פה בעצם, אנחנו משיקים היום גם את המדפסת הזו שהיא סמי-תעשייתית. ובואו נעבור למדפסת השנייה, שהשקה העולמית שלנו, שמדפיסה דג. פה, זו מדפסת שמדפיסה מוצר שמוכן לטיגון, מה שנקרא רדי מפוק. מכיל תאים אמיתיים, אנחנו מדפיסים פה בעצם פילה לוקוס. אין עוד חברה שיודעת לעשות דבר כזה. מכיל תאים אמיתיים, כשלוש דקות להתפסה. לוקוס עם טקסטורה מורכבת. עכשיו נזרוק את ה... אני לא יודע כבר זה מוכן. תן לה להדפיס, ככה זה נראה. ניתן את זה עוד רגע. פילה לוקוס מתורבת, שהודפס, מבלי... מי בעצם משתמש בדגס?
You expect fresh, clean sheets, but how would you know for sure? Well, our investigative team came up with a simple, kind of ingenious test.
We booked ourselves into 9 hotel rooms, and each time we sprayed this harmless, washable fluorescent paint onto the bed sheet using this stencil. I slept here glowing bold and bright. The next day, we booked the exact same room, but under a different name.
Okay, here we are back at the Candlewood Inn & Suites. We stayed in this room last night. We rechecked in. Let's take a look. These should be clean sheets. Let's see. Disgusting. These sheets are dirty. Look at this. I need a manager up here.
9:30, we're stepping in the service. Music, message, we don't want them to fly. Fun, fun, church can be fun. You know that it is.
And I have to confess, I knew nothing about their suffering until 2021, when I volunteered to help the Biden administration with the crisis at the southern border. As part of Operation Artemis, I was deployed to the Pomona Fairplex Emergency Intake Site in California to help HHS, Office of Refugee Resettlement, reunite children with sponsors in the United States. I thought I was going to help place children in loving homes. Instead, I discovered that children are being trafficked through a sophisticated network that begins with recruiting in home country, smuggling to the U.S. border, and ends when ORR delivers a child to a sponsor. Some sponsors are criminals and traffickers and members of transnational criminal organizations. Some sponsors view children as commodities and assets to be used for earning income. This is why we are witnessing an explosion of labor trafficking. Now, whether it's intentional or not, it could be argued that the United States government has become the middleman in a large-scale, multi-billion-dollar child trafficking operation that is run by bad actors seeking to profit off of the lives of children.
I am a real victim of Jeffrey Epstein. The reason you don't see me in the news is because I am a real victim. Real victims are not being represented by attorneys or in the media. I was trafficked to Jeffrey Epstein and Andrew Windsor by Deborah Palfrey, the DC madam. I was a student at the Catholic University of America in Washington, D.C. in 2002. I answered an ad in the city paper. The ad was ambiguous. Deborah was professional. I thought I was going on a real job interview. Instead, I was drugged and raped by Paul Hung. I tried to tell Deborah what happened, but something she said made me realize she knew what happened. At that point, they had my driver's license, and I did not know what to do or where to go for help. At that point, I was driven by Jonathan Luna to the Bethesda Marriott on Pook's Hill, where Jeffrey Epstein and Andrew Windsor drugged and raped me. I have tried to get help.
It's about to hit. So brace yourself, because you're going to get fired up. Two incredible CDs packed with over 2 hours of all your favorite dance hits. You can't get this two CD collection in any store.
JP Morgan is about to spend $1 billion on rental homes across the United States of America to become one of the biggest mega landlords in history. And they get ready to start right there in Atlanta, Georgia. Y'all are in some serious, serious trouble.
Do you think we need to worry about what they're putting in our electronics?
Yeah, I'll give you one example. I bought this awesome vacuum called Tinico. It completely connects to a Chinese server to transmit and receive information. Like when you plug it in, it says charging started, charging stopped. Like I can control that with my computer through a Chinese cloud server. There's no reason that that vacuum and mop should connect to a Chinese cloud, but it does. And at any point, they could change the way that functionality works and take over my home network with this vacuum mop.
So, are you serious with a vacuum mop?
Yep.
I want to show you something interesting. Look, I have a simple voltmeter here. One is in the ground, the minus. And the plus I have here. And now I'm wearing shoes, sort of. Yeah, I'm not connected with the ground. I touch the red pin. What does it say? 1 or sometimes 0. And look, when I touch my feet with my feet the ground, what happens? Hop. And hop. Think about it. When you wear shoes. That's why I don't do it anymore. Cheers.
You're saying if you have a media machine that purposefully lies to its people to maintain a political fiction and get themselves power, that is the hallmark of an authoritarian system, not a democratic system.
Absolutely.
Well, if we were ever to get something like that in the United States, we would be horrified, furious, to know that there was an entire media organization designed to bend reality, to manipulate facts, to maintain power. It would, if I may, and I don't, I'm not trying to slam Hungary, it would never happen in the United States. It's just not, I almost can't even conjure it, imagine it. It must be very difficult to live in a country where one media organization out of whole cloth, knowingly, explicitly, maybe even in meetings behind the scenes might say, we're lying to our audience, holy shit, and then call for news people to be fired for telling the truth. I mean, if something like that happened in the United States, it would be a dark day indeed. So I appreciate you raising the alarm bells for us.
First time ever, these dance club mega hits are all together on one non-stop party collection.
For an African,
to visit a European nation, an ordinary African, to visit an European nation is like, let me give you an example my teacher used to use. It's like trying to milk an elephant because of the visa process. However, for a European to visit an African nation, most of our nations, it is like a walk on the beach. It's like going to have a cup of tea. But then that is not the problem. The tragedy is that now for an African to visit a fellow African within the African Union, the visa restrictions in many of our nations, among us, between our brothers and sisters, is like trying to brush the teeth of a crocodile. They came, divided us, and they have taught us to keep each other from each other. Then they're mingling with each other and making money and growing, but they have taught us to hate each other. But for us to really enjoy the true economic benefits of the Africa Continental Free Trade Area, we need to behave like the Europeans and allow for the free movement of people and trade. Let us open our continent so that we can make money and live together. Let us remove the shackles of colonialism that are still embedded in our heads and be able to move forward.
I care about the planet, but guess what? This fucking pisses me off because this is a paper straw. Now, this paper straw is going to fall apart and make your drink suck halfway through it, and it's going to start getting disgusting, right? But the thing that makes me mad about it is it came in a plastic cup with a plastic cover.
You really need to adjust your attitude.
For questions or complaints, please contact the manufacturer.
If a person tells me that they are an example of black excellence, I will then ask them, give me an example of your quote-unquote black excellence. That black person will then proceed to say, well, I got a degree in this, this, that, and the other. Okay, well, do white people have a degree in this, this, that, and the other? Yes. Right. Okay, then it's not black excellence. Mm-hmm. Do Asian people have a degree in that? It's not black excellence. If you can show me one thing that is exclusively unique to black people that they can do that no other person can do, then I will agree with you that that's black excellence. If anybody else can do it, it's not black excellence. When I see these people in TikToks dancing and they have on their scrubs and all this, that, and the other, like, why can't you just be normal? Like, why can't you just be like, I don't see Asians on TikTok dancing because they got their medical license or what have you. It goes back to what Blanche was saying, is like, you're doing the stuff that you're supposed to do. If you take advantage of opportunity, it's something that you're supposed to do in the first place. But black folks will turn around and call that black excellence.
Did you know that Bo Jackson ran the fastest 40-yard dash in football history? At the 2017 Combine, John Ross ran a 4.22 40, which is recognized as the fastest ever. But Bo Jackson actually ran it faster than that multiple times, and the story is insane. So back when Bo was in college at Auburn, the school held a pro day in front of a bunch of NFL scouts. Bo didn't plan on participating because he had track practice. But all the scouts were begging to see him run the 40, so he agreed to do it. And his time was electronically clocked at a 4.13. But if you don't believe that story, there's more. In 1987, while practicing with the Oakland Raiders, he ran a 4.19 wearing football pads. Tom Flores, the Raiders head coach, couldn't believe it. He said something had to have been wrong. So they remeasured everything, Bo ran again, and this time he got a 4.17. Keep in mind, he did this at 230 pounds. That means he's faster than Tyreek Hill and weighs 40 more pounds than him. I really don't even think this should be a debate. Bo Jackson is the greatest athlete of all time. Between the strength, speed, and the fact he was an NFL Pro Bowler and MLB All-Star, we'll just unfortunately never see an athlete like this ever again. Just watch this clip right here. Bo was able to do things that nobody had ever seen before. It's a shame he wasn't able to stay healthy, and if you want to hear more stories like this, drop a follow.
Beginning, we were family. The beginning, there were no difference from each other. And if they were, it was just the land base. And that's like in our language, Anikida, you know, it always was referenced to, that's your relative, that's your relative, that's your relative.
Do you know any natural bug repellents?
Tea tree oil, vanilla extract, and the rosemary you can combine together. In the almond oil base, that's a natural way of repelling the bugs.
Will that work for mosquitoes too?
It will.
Yesterday was Saturday, and Monday comes after church. I don't want the service.
Jay and Breezy in the house!
Going to church on Sunday.
Yeah! It's Sunday morning.
Almost every weekend, Pastor Jim's preaching.
Except today, it's Tim.
I can see I ain't the type you're used to dealing with. Bad bitch, never off the bench, I'm a starter. Savage, I just grind and go harder. Cash this, I don't own a payment, nothing borrowed. Spin it, cause I can make some more paper tomorrow.
I'm blue, I'm a need, I'm a
order fired up.
up online at musicspace.com.
And that's what takes me high.
Get fired up now and sleep later. To order, call the number on your screen or log on to musicspace.com. Rush delivery available.
Hey people, did you see this? Rocks falling from the sky in Romania? Yeah, hail, but stones. And it looks like there's more to this than just a freak storm. After this clip, I'll tell ya. That was Romania, but they got something else going on there. Mysterious sounds, booms in the sky, something like sonic booms, have been happening in Romania, and they're freaking people out. Of course it's freaking people out. Sonic booms and rocks falling from the sky? What could it mean?
NASA admitted that it had lost the original footage of man's first steps on the moon.
It was all recorded on these telemetry tapes. So where is this hard evidence?
I haven't seen anything that indicates the telemetry data is even in existence. And as I said, even if we had it, we don't have the machines to play it back.
But your own research has shown the telemetry data is missing.
That's right.
If it's anywhere, it should be here at NASA's Goddard Space Center in Maryland, home to the National Space Science Data Archives.
This film you're making now, what is it? Does it have a name? I mean, do you have a name for it yet, or are you?
I'm calling it Did We Go?
Did We Go? Okay, okay.
Doesn't have it either. The Smithsonian
right.
doesn't have it.
Right.
Johnson doesn't
right.
have it.
Right. Right. We've been unable to track it down. I mean, we don't know where this telemetry data ended up, and we don't know what path it may have taken. So. Unfortunately, I'm afraid I can't really give you much of a clue as to where this data ended up and whether it still exists.
Kids who think that they can do their own research.
Don't do any of your own research.
Doing your own research is associated with conspiracy theory circles.
This go-it-alone approach, doing your own research,
that can have serious consequences.
You should get prison time for even questioning the vaccines.
Can we all stop saying, I need to do my own research?
That phrase, do your own research, four words, four little words that are hurting America.
Doing your own research hurts America.
Everybody has a supercomputer in their hand that empowers them to do their own research, and that's the problem.
You must not do your own research.
I need to do my own research.
I don't ever understand what that means.
I'm doing my own research.
You can't do your own research unless you're a scientist.
Don't do your own research.
Maybe you've told yourself you're playing it safe, you just want to wait and see since this is a new vaccine. No.
Grow the f*** up and get the vaccine.
Unvaccinated people spread